भगवान नरसिंह देव की जय, भक्त श्रोणी प्रहलाद महाराज की जय, श्री प्रभुपाद की जय। वेलकम टू लॉर्ड नरसिंह देव पास्ट टाइम सेशन। टुडे इज द फोर्थ डे, सो वी आर शेयरिंग एवरी डे वन स्टोरी, वन और टू स्टोरीज ऑफ लॉर्ड नरसिंह देव विच हैपन इन द रीसेंट पास्ट टाइम। ओके, सो टुडे ऑल्सो आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर अ स्टोरी विच हैपन समवेयर बैक इन 2005 इन मायापुर, West Bengal. Okay, so what happened there? There was an 8-year-old child. Her name was Revati, and she was just in the residential area. There are some bamboo huts, you know. So she was climbing on the roof of that bamboo hut, and somehow she slipped and she fell down, and actually some wooden stick was broken. So she fell down because of that, and then the whole rooftop also fell down on her head. She was small, maybe 8-year-old, and she was so much got kind of trauma because of that incident, and a lot of injuries were there. And then they immediately took her to the nearby hospital, which was a homeopathy hospital. They gave some treatment, and but she was not able to speak anything because of the trauma and that heavy load which fell down on her head, and then she was very much scared. So they were treating her, and then the third night, what happened that she was in the night, some blood came out of her nose and mouth. She was vomiting blood again and again. Now, many times she vomited blood, and then some kind of liquid was coming out of her nose, and then after some time some blood started coming out of her nose, and that made everybody very scared, and the whole, and they took her to the Kolkata, and there a lot of some neurosurgeon hospital and everywhere they took, and they were doing a lot of checkups, what happened, and then they, many hospitals they went, then somewhere they asked him to do CT scan. So they were doing it, and then they got some reports. But meanwhile, other treatment were also going on to control this bleeding from the nose and like that, but nothing was coming in control. And then soon the scanning was done, then the report came after some time, and in the report it was found that there was some head injury kind of thing which made a big some part of the brain got damaged, and from there that liquid was coming out, and in another part of the brain there was some, because of this injury there was some blood clotting, and because of that she was feeling unconscious, and her BP was so much high. And like that, a lot of problems were there. So the doctors were not able to sure whether they should go for a surgery or not. So they were having a long meeting what to do, because it seems very critical case. Then the doctors decided that they cannot take any decision, they need some further guidance from some senior doctors. So they said to the family that we will call some other senior doctors team, and they will have some special scanning which will give more clear idea at exactly where, in which part the problem is there, and after understanding that only we will be able to do surgery. So they said okay, so tomorrow there will be a neurosurgeons team, and they will do the special scanning, and then we will tell you what to do, what can we do by the morning 9 a.m. So this was the information. Then this child, her grandmother, she called up in the Mayapur temple Pujari, His Grace Pankajangri Prabhu, and she called and she told the whole situation, and then she requested that this is the case, so please pray for my granddaughter and offer a special puja to Sri Lord Narsingdev. So Pujari understood the situation, and Prabhuji said okay, we will do it early morning, 5 o'clock there is Abhishekam for Lord Narasimhadev, so we will do it there and a special puja. So 5 o'clock next day, Pujari, his guest from Jangi Babu, did a special puja for the daughter, for the small child, and made a special Abhishekam, offering everything, and prayed, especially prayed for her well-being. And actually that was a time when in the hospital at the same time scanning was also going on. Here the Pujari was worshipping and praying for her, and there scanning was going on. And later on the scanning, when it was done, then the report came. So 9 o'clock when they approached doctor for asking the results, so all these doctors, including the senior doctors who came to do scanning, all the doctors was amazed. They were so much surprised that how come it happened, because in the special scanning there was no problem, there was no clotting, there was no damage, there was no bleeding, and her BP was extremely normal, and there was no blood vomiting, there was nothing coming out her nose, everything was pakka, very nice. And the doctors were telling, within one night it seems there happened some kind of miracle, because of which everything became normal. Right. So in this way Lord Narasimhadev blessed the child and protected her life. And later on this small child always said to her grandmother that anything happens to me, don't go to doctor and don't waste your time and money, just take me to Lord Narasimhadev. And this small girl got his strong faith in the mercy of Lord Narasimhadev. Narasimha Bhagwan ki jai. So in this way we have seen that how Lord Narasimhadev, everybody was witnessing this incident and everybody understood that how Lord Narasimhadev mercifully protected the devotees. So there is another time recently what happened, that one student, he was sleeping in the night and he got a dream. So in the dream there was a big palace, you know, and actually when this, the night this happened, after 6 or 7 days only he called me and told this whole thing. So then he was sleeping on that day and in the night, and he saw a dream. There was a big old palace, it's like khandar, very old one, and he reached there and he was just walking inside the palace alone, and there was some old things, and then all of a sudden he felt that somebody spoke in his ear, and he was like scared. It was very grave voice, and it also, the voice also echoed, but he also felt that somebody is speaking in the ear, and that voice said that, so finally you have come, it took so long for you to come here, like that he heard it. Then he was scared, and then all of a sudden there was so much kind of fearful voices, and then somebody pushed him, and somebody caught hold from the back near the belt and lifted him. So, and he was pushing, so he felt very scared. And then what happened, that all of a sudden he woke up, because it was a dream. He woke up and then he goes, oh my god, this was a dream. Then what happened, that he soon after he woke up, he realized that there is some kind of burning sensation on his back. So in the waist where he saw in the dream that somebody actually pushed him and lifted him, so he felt some kind of scratching, like somebody scratched him, so that kind of itching, that kind of burning sensation he was feeling, and some pain he was feeling. Then he was wondering that it was a dream, then how he is feeling everything in the real. So he was like very scared and he did not speak to anyone. And then the next night again same thing happened, and this time somebody hit him on the legs, and then he was feeling the same burning sensation on the legs. So everything was happening in dream, but that pain and burning sensation was coming to his body in real. He was getting scared, and then every day it was happening. Then after 5-6 days he called and he informed that this thing is happening, I am not able to sleep properly, I am very scared, that's why I am telling you, so please tell me what to do. So I just spoke to him and I told him, see, Lord Narsingdev can protect everyone, he is the most powerful. So you pray to Lord Narsingdev, and I told him, Narsimha Kavacha, Anugram Viram Mahavishnu Jalantam Sarvatomukam Narsingam Bhishnam Badram Mrityor Mrityum Namam, this mantra I told him. So I asked that you can please chant this mantra. So that night, that means seventh night, he was chanting this mantra 108 time, and Narsimha Kavach he was chanting, and then he played this mantra in audio and he slept. And I asked him to keep Lord Narsingdev photo near and pray to him and then sleep. Take a good bath and make yourself clean and pure. So then this boy did like that and he slept. And then the next morning when he woke up, he was very happy and he called me that today night nothing happened. And then again next morning, like that, it happened that nothing he experienced. And then since then till today, nothing he is experiencing and all those problems are gone. And now he is peaceful, and but every day he is following the same thing and Lord Narsingdev is protecting him. So in this way we see that how merciful is Lord Narsingdev. Narsingdev Bhagavan ki jai, Bhakti Shiromani Prahlad Maharaj ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Hare Krishna.